morning, everybody. It's a great day at Illinois Tech. Welcome to the 2016 Alumni Awards Ceremony and Luncheon. We are so happy that you are all here today. And I've been told it's going to be 80 and sunny when we finish, so you can take a lovely tour of campus. We start with the most important order of the day, and that is to welcome all of those who are our winners. The applause can be raucous as long as you can hear me say their name. And please, winners, please stand when I say your name. We start with the family of Bob Bonthron. Stand up. Patrick Bourbon. Barbara Crane. Come on, stand up. Ted Erickson. Michael Graff. Ronald Hochsprung. Stay standing, you winners. The family of Howard Carroll. Jules Knapp. James Lemke. Akihisa Miwa. Vasudevan Rajaram. Derek Tarnow. Zara Takakorinia. And Bud Wendorf. This is good. We have competition. It sounds like the Erickson crowd, the Knapp crowd, the Wendorf crowd. So the rest of you, you have to yell really loud when it comes along. So congratulations to all of you. Please feel free to enjoy your salads as we start the program. I want to first start by welcoming President Alan Cram and his wife Anna, who are up front here. Our former president, Pat John Anderson, his wife Pat. Our provost, Francis Burnett, and there are many members of the university administration. Could I ask all of those folks to stand so we can thank and welcome you? President, too. Former president, too. Thank you all for being here. I also want to extend a very special thanks to all those loud and raucous and wonderful family members and friends who are here today to make this day extra special for their winners. We also have a number of students with us, even though finals week begins on Monday. So these are spectacular students. I encourage you to get to know them over lunch. For the alumni, they're going to tell you the truth. What are things like today, and indeed that classes are just as tough as you remember them to be? Could the students all stand so we can recognize you? I feel like some of them are standing out in the hallway. Friends, we have to work on that. Because I do want to point out that we have our current, our former, and our incoming Student Government Association presidents here. And I feel like they're not all here, right? But Akinadi Adarelli, Rahul Radwani, and the future student government president, please stand, Hamza Sukar. Are Akinadi and Rahul here? I saw Rahul standing outside. They're around. So wonderful, wonderful campus leaders. We had a female student in the job for a couple of years, and finally the men got it back. And they've had it now for 3 years, so we'll move on. Before we begin, I want to tell you what our time together will be like. So in a moment, you'll hear from our Alumni Awards Committee Chair, and then from our President, Alan Cram, who will give you a university update. And then we're going to present a very special award, the only award that is given today to someone who did not graduate from IIT, a very special award in Bob Galvin's memory, the Galvin Award. Then we'll take a break, we'll have lunch, and after lunch, we'll come back and present all of the alumni awards. And now it's my honor to introduce Scott Turnovitz. Scott is an alumni board member and chair of the awards committee that makes the tough decisions that results in today's winners. Scott and I are old buds. He is a 1992 graduate of the Institute of Design, comes from a spectacular Illinois Tech family. His parents are both graduates of the College of Architecture. His brother Craig is also an alum. And who better to chair the Alumni Awards Committee than a previous winner? Scott won the Outstanding Young Alumnus Award in 2000. Please welcome Scott Turnovitz.
Hi. I will keep this short, as unfortunately we're not here about me. But I do have a lot of people to thank. I'm honored to be here today. I'm honored to be here today as the chairman of the Alumni Committee. And before we kind of talk about the awards and those things, I want to talk a little bit about the committee and thank the committee. So this is a tough job. I've talked before about sort of the thick book that we have to go through in order to understand what's going on. But the tough part of it that I don't think people realize is you actually need a degree just to look at the things that the people have accomplished with these awards. They're crazy. They range from sort of legal to chemistry to the amazing worlds in technology that quite literally I feel like I have a limited understanding of without doing a bunch of research. It's really phenomenal things. So will the people that are on the committee please rise for a minute and accept a round of applause from all of us. Okay. The second group of people I would like to thank is the staff and the alumni relations at IIT. We really couldn't pull this off without those folks, Kelly and Betsy and all of the rest. I think they do a wonderful job putting all of this together because it is so important that we recognize these things. My job is basically in innovation. I'm an innovation consultant, and I spend a lot of my time looking forward. What's the future going to be about? And technology plays a huge role in that future. And one of the things that's very apparent if you're really looking at that space is the rate of change and things that are happening right now. From essentially synthetic biology to machine learning to all of the other, to the legal implications that these things bring about, that world is changing, and it's changing the experiences that we're all having, and it's changing the ways that we interact with things. And what's really nice about today is we can actually take, and instead of looking forward, we can look back, and we can look at a lot of the foundational things that make this change possible, that make this time that we're living in so exciting at the moment. We can kind of take a little bit of a retrospective view. So this day isn't only about the winners today. This day is really also looking back at the 76 or so years that we've had these awards, that we've really been honoring IIT students for building the technologies, the thought leadership, the foundational material around which these great achievements are today. So just a quick round of applause for all of the former winners in the past that we've had. And then lastly, final thank you, and I think the thing that I have to do up here is everyone here and that is part of the IIT community currently is pushing technology and how we live forward. The changes that we see on a day-to-day basis, I'm astounded when I find classmates in different corners of the planet right now that are changing social structure and social innovation and material sciences and all kinds of these amazing spaces. And I think we all should be very proud of what an IIT education can do to move the world forward and make the kind of changes that we all know are necessary in order for things to be more productive and for this to be a greater place. So cheers to all of you, and thank you very much.
Thank you, Scott. One last thank you to the members of the Alumni Board, many of whom who are here from around the country. I'm going to make them all stand up as well. And they are led by Andrea Berry up front here. Thank you all to the Alumni Board. They work very hard throughout the year. Okay, why are we being shy, kids? Thank you. Awesome. Thank you. There you go. Good job. Now we have the great privilege of hearing from President of Illinois Tech, Alan Cram. Many of you know Alan, who had been our provost for many years, but since we have visitors in the room, I'd like to give you a brief introduction to Alan. He earned his BS in metallurgy from Strathclyde University, Glasgow, and his PhD in materials science from the University of Pennsylvania. He then spent many years conducting and managing research within the steel industry. In 1986, he made the move to higher ed, joining the faculty at Carnegie Mellon University, where he worked with our former president, John Anderson. And in 2005, he became Dean of Engineering at Rensselaer Polytech Institute. Alan came to IIT as Provost and Senior Vice President of Academic Affairs in 2008, focused very much on revitalizing the academic programs and the faculty, and led the development of our current strategic plan. He's the author of more than 200 publications, holds 2 patents, has won many, many awards. My favorite is the one he's won twice, the American Institute of Iron and Steel Metal. He served as president of the American Institute of Mining, Metallurgical, and Petroleum Engineers, and last year he was inducted into the prestigious National Academy of Engineering for his contributions to the development of high-integrity, continuously cast steels. But Alan's most recent honor is his induction as a fellow in the National Academy of Inventors earlier this month at the United States Patent and Trademark Office. It was after a unanimous vote of confidence from the Board of Trustees that Alan assumed the role of president last summer. Since his inauguration as Illinois Tech's 9th president in September, he's been traveling the world, meeting alumni. His vision, his enthusiasm, his experience make him the perfect person for the job. Please welcome the president of Illinois Institute of Technology, Alan Cram.
Well, what a wonderful day to look out here and see all of our alumni here, all having done so many great things. You know, I always say that a university is defined by its alumni, and it's great alumni that make a great university. And this past year, I've been traveling around the world and throughout the United States to meet various different alumni groups. And I've just been amazed at the accomplishment of all of the groups, all of the people that I meet in all of the places I've gone, whether it's San Diego or whether it's New York City or whether it's in Tokyo. It's just amazing the accomplishment of our graduates. And I think today we're celebrating the accomplishment of our graduates and the accomplishment of our alumni winners here. But first of all, I'd like to introduce the members of the Board of Trustees that are here today. And when I call your name, I'd like you to stand. Andrea Berry, Mike Graff, Ed Kaplan, Jules Knapp, Sherry Littlejohn, Madhavan Nair, Bud Wendorf, and Walter Nathan. Let's give them a round of applause. You know, this time I should say something about the state of the university. And the first thing I want to say to you all is these are great days for your university. Our faculty are having unprecedented success in research and gaining very prestigious awards. We had 5 of our newer faculty win the NSF Young Investigator Award. This is a national competition. We won more of these awards than anyone else in Illinois and anyone else in the Midwest, and the most we ever had, just to show that the standard of the faculty that we're hiring in science and engineering are outstanding. But not just in science and engineering, we have 2 of our architecture faculty who are actually been chosen in international competitions. One of them is a finalist for the Obama Library, and we have many other of our architects and designers who have done amazingly well. I could go through this in all the schools. We have tremendous strength in our faculty everywhere, but it's great to see we're being recognized by others, and we can talk about what others think of our faculty, just truly outstanding. Our student body has been growing over the last few years, and the quality of the student body has been growing also. But not only that, our student body is changing. The millennials, we see many things written about millennials, but the great thing about our student body is not only do they study hard, not only do they work hard, but they also want to help humanity. I know in engineering they're focused on projects, on water, on energy, etc., all related to major problems of humanity. But our total student body want to give back. I want you all to know that the students of today want to give back. They come here, and the most popular thing happening now is alternative spring break. Instead of going to Florida or Mexico and spending a week in the sun, many of our students now are going to Appalachia to help build houses in alternative spring break. Whenever we have a day of service in Chicago, many of our students want to go out and really help the local environments. We have many projects going on in the local neighborhoods and in Chicago as a whole. So it's an amazing time for the university to see this. One of the things I'd like you also to know is that main building, as you know, we had to close it a couple of years ago, but it actually is coming back. We have a developer who's going to turn it into apartments for young professionals and very rich students, I would think, but of which we have some too. But this is a great thing because all of a sudden we're going to have another area that's going to attract people to live in our campus. We're looking to build a new Kaplan Innovation Center, which will be in Morton Park. So hopefully this will be one of the last times you'll ever see green space in Morton Park the way you're seeing it just now. Also, we're looking to renovate Bailey and Cunningham Halls to bring world-class, state-of-the-art student life residences for our students. So it's an exciting time as we look forward. Also, there's tremendous changes going on in our buildings. We renovated a number of buildings recently, renamed some of them, but the Engineering One, as it used to be called, is now the John T. Retaliata Center. And if you get an opportunity this afternoon to go over there, you'll see a state-of-the-art, world-class facility for students where they can work together, play together, and actually achieve a lot together. And it's a new type of space helped designed by our Dean of Engineering, Natasha DePaula. So actually many great things are happening in the university. I think our future is really bright. We're really fortunate that the plans that were begun by Lou Collins and then carried on by John Anderson, my two predecessors, have put me in a position that my goal is to continue the forward momentum of our university and make sure we achieve everything that we want to achieve. But I want you all to know we're still true to how we started. We still are a home to outstanding academic students from children from Chicago who are of modest means, and we make it work for those students. So it's how we started, and we still have a significant group of students from Chicago here that we enable them to be engineers, scientists, architects, business majors, psychologists, it doesn't matter. If they make our standards, we still make it possible for them to come here. And I'm very proud of us that we are true to the original mission of our university. However, I know I'm only meant to speak for a short time. As one of my friends said to me, Alan, has anyone ever come up to you after a speech and said, you should have spoken longer? I had to think about that for a little while. Anyway, it's now my pleasure to introduce our chairman of the board of trustees and, of course, this year's alumni medal recipient, Bernd Windorf. You'll hear much more about Bud later, but right now he's going to join us to present the Galvin Award.
Thank you, Alan. You know, I enjoy this day, and if you pay attention, I think you can always learn things that you didn't otherwise know. That's already been true for me because I knew that Alan was a distinguished person in his career and in academia, but I didn't know, Alan, that you were an inventor. So this was new to me, and I'll tell you what made me think of this. John Anderson and I were speaking a couple months ago of the passing out in California of the former president of USC, Steve Sample. And Dr. Sample was really a great president for them. But one of the things that was interesting about Steve Sample was that he invented and patented the keypad for microwave ovens. And he subsequently gave, I think, about $3 gazillion to USC. So, Alan, what is it that you patented? Well, I digress. More to follow. I am honored to present a very special award, the first of the day, and the only one given to an individual who did not attend IIT. The Galvin Award was established in 2010 in honor of Bob Galvin. Bob led Motorola as CEO for many years and also led Illinois Tech as chairman of the Board of Trustees and as a university regent. Bob chaired the National Commission for IIT and helped chart the course that the university is on today. His extraordinary philanthropy truly transformed this institution. Mr. Galvin did all of this despite the fact that Illinois Tech was not his alma mater. Bob Galvin chose to dedicate his service to this university for more than 50 years because it was a place where he felt he could truly make a difference. And that holds true for this year's Galvin winner as well. Jules Knapp is a natural salesman. He's worked since a young boy and credits the example of his mother, Esther, for helping him develop his great work ethic. The combinations of sales talent and hard work served Jules throughout his career. Back in 1949, Jules was searching for a career path after getting an associate's degree. He was working for an employment agency when he got a call from a company that had a job selling paintbrushes. They were looking for someone who was young and aggressive, and he recalls that it paid $100 a week, a lot of money back then. He embarked on his career in the paint industry, and he never looked back. After a brief interruption for service in the Army in Germany, Jules rushed back to the paintbrush company, where he tells us he had some of great mentors who helped him inform his approach to integrity in business. Soon, he ventured out and started his own paint company, United Coatings. Over decades, he grew the company into the largest private label paint company in the country with six plants. In 1994, the company merged with Pratt & Lambert and put the company on the New York Stock Exchange, and in 1996, it was purchased by Sherwin-Williams. Since the sale, Jules has continued purchasing and running businesses, but he also gives back generously of his time to young entrepreneurs, mentoring them and helping them navigate the possible pitfalls of startups. Jules' first exposure to Illinois Tech came through an introduction through trustee Al Gorman, and soon he was very involved here, serving as a member of the Stewart School of Business Board of Advisors, a trustee, and a generous donor whose gifts helped form the Knapp Entrepreneurship Center. Jules and his wife, Gwen, give generously to many worthy causes throughout Chicago, such as the Merritt School of Music and the Joy Faith Knapp Children's Center, named in honor of their late daughter, Joy, who passed away from complications of lupus in 2000. The Knapps have also funded research into autoimmune diseases such as lupus at the University of Chicago Biological Sciences Division and Medical Center, and was awarded the Chicago Medal from the university in 2007. Jules has commented that giving back is central to his Jewish faith. We are grateful that he has chosen to give time, his experience, and his resources to the School of Stewart School of Business and Illinois Tech. I have to digress a bit from my script and just mention a few personal comments. Jules serves with me on our Board of Trustees. He's truly a great guy. He has a wonderful sense of humor, extremely smart. When you meet him, the first time you know this guy is on the ball, and a wonderful gentleman and an accomplished person. And number two thing that I've learned today, Jules is also an excellent golfer. And I played golf with Jules, and I didn't know how excellent he was, but he's passed my test of truly being a top-notch golfer. He's been able to shoot his age. So I would like to now present the 2016 Galvin Award to Jules Knapp.
Thank you. When you're as old as I am, it's very easy to shoot your age. I was asked to speak for 2 minutes. And thank the Lord, I was only asked for 2 minutes. Because if it was more, I would need a teleprompter, I need a script, and I have my cue cards. But since I only have 2 minutes, I don't need a script, I don't need a teleprompter, the cue cards. But I'd like to tell one story, and I may run over a little. I'd like to talk about Bob Galvin. I was invited to a business meeting where there was about 200 people who wanted to give money. And our keynote speaker was Bob Galvin. He got up on a podium during dinner and spoke for over 30 minutes. There was not a teleprompter, there was not a cue card or a script, and no ers, ahs, uh. He spoke fluently, clearly for over 35 minutes. He was a remarkable, remarkable man. And again, I want to thank you for this award, Alan, Bud, and the fella. And anyway, I'm glad I don't have a teleprompter because I'm out of words right now. Thank you again.
Thank Jules' family for being here. One of the other wonderful things that he has done for us is bring new friends to IIT who are on the NAP board, and there are many of those folks here today as well. We thank them for being here. We had hoped that Mrs. Galvin would be with us today. Didn't turn out, but we will send her a videotape of this so she can hear Jules' wonderful remarks. Thank you again and congratulations. Now it's time for lunch. I see some of you followed instructions and ate your salad. For others, you're gonna lose that really fast, so take some bites. So your entree is about to arrive, and we'll be back after lunch with the Alumni Awards. Thank you. So let's get started. I hope you all enjoyed your lunch and having time to visit with family and friends and alumni that perhaps you didn't know. So, please forgive my use of notes. I have so much that I want to tell you about these people, but you can also follow along with the program book that's at your place. It gives you a little more color commentary as well. And I'm going to call forth President Cram and Scott Chernovitz, who will present the awards to our winners. And I want to recognize and acknowledge Gina Qualter and Paige Mass, our student leaders, who will be escorting our winners up to the stage to get their awards. Good? Ready? Shall we start? Everybody in place? Do note that Zach Russ wears white gloves to hand you the award. We do not want fingerprints on your IIT award. First up, we have the Outstanding Young Alumnus Award. This year, given to three alumni who are 40 years of age or younger, who have already demonstrated extraordinary success and leadership in their careers. Our first honoree, Patrick Bourbon, is already responsible for managing a total of $2 billion in assets for financial clients. Patrick founded his own financial planning firm, Bourbon Financial Management, in 2009. He has also served as the chief investment officer for ProManage since 2010. Patrick comes from a family of PhDs in Toulouse, France. He first came to the United States at 14 years old as a high school exchange student, found that he liked America so much that he came back 2 years later on a all-you-can-fly ticket. That sounds fun, to 15 cities across the U.S. in a month. Even then, he knew how to get a good deal for his money. And during that trip to Chicago, he fell in love and came back in 1996 to work for the National Bank of Paris in Chicago. In 1999, after being admitted to several business schools, we're lucky that he chose to pursue a master's in finance at Illinois Tech. Patrick had already completed a master's in engineering degree in France at the prestigious EPF Graduate School of Engineering. Professor John Bilson, who I think is here today, the Stewart School of Business, nominated Patrick for this award for his professional achievements. Professor Bilson recognized Patrick for his tremendous service to the Stewart School, where he is a member of the Board of Advisors and director of the Stewart Committee for the Illinois Tech Chicagoland Alumni Chapter. Patrick has also chaired Stewart Investments, a nonprofit organization made up of Illinois Tech students, for the last 8 years. Under his coaching, Stewart Investments has doubled the value of the funds that they manage, delivering financial returns that are among the top 3% for all professional funds in the United States. Pretty impressive. Big thank you to Patrick for your work on behalf of the Stewart School, and congratulations. For all the winners and all the families, you get awesome photos from us. So I love that Derek's dad is over here with his iPhone, but we're gonna send you stuff too. Good. And these big pictures, suitable for framing and hanging over your fireplace in the living room, we send you those too. Those are fun. Our next Outstanding Young Alumni Award goes to a dynamic duo. We're presenting two awards in one this year to Derek Tarnow and Zara Tashakorinia, who both earned their Master of Design degrees from our Institute of Design in 2012. Derek and Zara created the Tidy Tilt iPhone accessory. Who has one? For a product design workshop at the Institute of Design. They then built on that project, developing Tidy Tilt Plus and Just Mount before their company, TT Design Labs, was acquired by Logitech in 2013, less than a year after they graduated from ID. These two are not only partners in receiving this award, they're also professional partners, their friendship having begun as ID students when Tidy Tilt was just a gleam in their eye. Their assigned seats next to each other in class led to friendship, which led to working together. They tell us that a great perk about being seated next to each other is when they had to pair up for group projects, nobody had to move their chair. Their chairs are a little farther away now, with Derek on the East Coast and Zara on the West, but they still consider themselves partners while they work on different teams at Logitech. But you can imagine how fun it is to walk by people on the street and see them using their products. And several times they have stopped Tidy Tilt users on the street to say, "How do you like it?" But they don't admit that they're the inventor of it. Derek and Zara love hearing stories about how people have discovered their product and how they even encourage others to buy it. So life has been a bit of a whirlwind for these two since their time at ID. They both say it's been an amazing ride, and they're still a little surprised that this is indeed their life. They owe a lot to their parents. I know Derek's family is here. Zara has a guest here too with them. And they say attending ID felt like they were a member of a cool design club rather than students attending class. And they wish they could do it all over again. Congratulations, Derek and Zara. Our next award goes to a graduate of Illinois Tech who excelled in both leadership and performance as a student athlete and who went on to achieve significant success after graduation. This year, the John J. Schomer Honor I Award goes to Ted Erickson. Just wait until you hear this guy's story. You have to sit here and let me brag about you for a while. Ted joined the swim team the day he registered. Now you have to listen, Ted, so we get to talk about you. Ted joined the swim team the day he registered at Illinois Tech in 1948. He went on to set 6 swim team records and to serve as the captain for 2 seasons. He later coached the team for 2 years while he was working as a senior chemist at ITRE, the IT Research Institute. At ITRE, Ted did significant research on propellants. He tells us he scored a major victory by winning a large government contract for the study of ozone stabilization, beating out chief academic rivals. His master's thesis, Thermodynamics of the Steady State, formed the basis for extensive studies of vaporization under U.S. Air Force scientific research contracts. But today's award is not just for those professional achievements, it's for the combination of athletic and professional success. And that brings us back to the water. Ted became the first person to swim Lake Michigan when Chicago car salesman Jim, the courtesy man, Moran, offered $3,675, or $100 a mile, to the first person who could swim from Chicago to Michigan City, Indiana. Perhaps some of you longtime Chicagoans remember Jim Moran and his challenge, which I understand was big headlines in the day. Alaskan swimmer Harry Briggs tried it 3 times and failed. So in 1961, Ted decided to give it a whirl. While he was in the water, a storm blew up, pulling him off course, and it took him 36 and a half hours to swim 43 miles. When he crawled up on the break wall in Michigan City, he was greeted by 10,000 spectators. They told him they were looking for some swimmer who was coming from Chicago. So he got back in the water, swam to the beach, where he could then be greeted by the crowd and make history. There's more. And then in 1965, at the age of 37, Ted set the world record for the fastest round-trip swim of the English Channel, beating the existing record by 13 hours. His record went unbroken for a decade until Ted's late son, John, another marathon swimmer and world record breaker, bested it at the age of 21. In 1967, Ted became the first person to swim from the Farallon Islands off the coast of California to the Golden Gate Bridge in San Francisco. He was without a wetsuit in icy and shark-infested waters. No swimmer was able to duplicate his achievement until nearly a half century later in 2014. Today, Ted still swims regularly in the much tamer Echo Pool at the Keating Athletic Center at IIT. In 2015, the Illinois Tech swim team named their invitational swim in his honor. And in response, Ted made the entire team swim caps, commemorating his son, John, who passed away in 2014. When Ted is asked what drove him to become one of the greatest professional swimmers in Chicago history, he says, "I didn't do it for the money. I did it for the glory." Congratulations, Ted. Alan. I would like you all to notice that Ted is wearing his IIT golden medallion. He truly never goes anywhere without it. And for you youngsters in the room, when you hit your 50th reunion, you come to a lovely lunch in this room, and you too can have a golden medallion, just like Ted's. What an amazing story. Our next award category is the Professional Achievement Award, which honors alumni whose achievements in their fields have brought distinction to themselves as well as credit to Illinois Tech. This is the category that gives our judges the greatest challenges every year because we have so many extraordinary nominees. And today we have 3 recipients. Pardon me. Our first winner has been described as pioneering, legendary, and a paragon of photographic experimentation by art curators and critics. Forgive me. Barbara Crane has won numerous awards and honors, including 2 National Endowment for the Arts Visual Arts Fellowships. Her work is in the collections of the Museum of Modern Art in New York City, the John Guggenheim Foundation, The Smithsonian Institution National Museum of American Art, and many other museums worldwide. Barbara graduated in 1966 from the Seminole Master of Photography program at the Institute of Design. Art historian Lloyd Engelbrecht wrote that in founding the ID, Laszlo Moholy-Nagy began a Chicago experiment that would revolutionize both the teaching and practice of photography throughout the country. Art critic Victor Cassidy considers Barbara, quote, the spiritual grandchild of Moholy-Nagy for her commitment to radical experimentation and series photography. Barbara holds a bachelor's degree from New York University in art history, a subject which gave her the insight to create groundbreaking images. As a young commercial photographer in New York City, Barbara would show her work anywhere people would let her, including the windows of a meat market. Her children helped her career by giving her critical feedback, by being willing to pose for the camera, and by knowing that without fail, they could always find mom in the darkroom. Barbara's husband, John Miller, who's with us today, is a successful abstract expressionist painter. The two met 20 years ago at the Art Institute of Chicago, where they were both professors. They share adjoining work studios where their dog, Sloopy, they call him their art dog, accompanies them every day. I want to show you just a few of Barbara's photographs, starting with her master's thesis, Human Forms, and moving through her abstract series and portraits of Chicago life. Barbara tells us she does not have any hobbies besides visiting her grandchildren, but she does have a collection of something that I'm guessing no one else in the room might have. She collects dead animal carcasses in order to photograph them. The last time we talked to her, she had two dead mice, two dead birds in her freezer. Whatever it takes, Barbara, congratulations on your wonderful award. Michael Graff is our next Professional Achievement Award winner, and this man clearly deserves any award with the words professional and achievement in the title. But before he became chairman and CEO of Global Glass Solutions and Technologies Corporation, Air Liquide Holdings, Mike was just a kid growing up on Chicago's South Side. He tells us he spent a lot of his childhood helping out in his grandparents' farm outside of Chicago, and that he developed much of his work ethic from those days on the farm. Mike had a natural aptitude for math and science and an innate curiosity. He first came to Illinois Tech as a high schooler on a campus visit day, and he sat in on a junior level science class, and he remembers saying, "Hey, I can do this," and did it. Like so many Illinois Tech alumni, Mike became the first in his family to earn a college degree despite having to work full time while in school. But he did not stop with his chemical engineering degree from Illinois Tech. He earned his graduate degree from Purdue, completed several prestigious graduate programs, and is a true believer in lifelong learning. Mike gives back in many ways, mentoring others and serving on numerous civic and community boards in Houston. For many years when they lived in Illinois, he took time to coach youth athletic teams, and on his return visits to Chicago, he's often recognized as "Hey Coach" when he's out and about. He gives back to his alma maters as well, serving on the Illinois Tech Board of Trustees and on a chemical engineering advisory board at Purdue. In 2015, he received the Charles Pierce Alumni Award from Illinois Tech's Armour College Department of Chemical and Biological Engineering. While his natural intelligence and strong work ethic clearly paved the way for his success, Mike does credit the rigor of an Illinois Tech education with providing him with critical skills. He tells us that Professor Ralph Peck's thermodynamic class was legendary. and many of you agree. He tells us that Professor Peck's pop quizzes emerged in the last 3 minutes of class, where he would ask students to take out a blank sheet of paper and solve one tough problem. In other words, you either got a 0 or a 10. That training, says Mike, taught him to think on his feet and to approach problem solving in creative ways. Mike, we're so happy to have you on campus today. Years later, we can finally reward you for that hard work in class and the success that followed with the Professional Achievement Award. Congratulations. Thank you. Our next, thank you. And the third Professional Achievement Award today goes to Jim Lemke. Jim was not able to be with us today, but we presented his award at a wonderful San Diego area alumni event in February. But let me tell you a little about Jim. He's a successful serial entrepreneur who has built his businesses upon his knowledge of theoretical physics. He holds 3 degrees on the subject, a bachelor's degree from Illinois Tech, master's degree that he obtained from the Woodrow Wilson Fellowship at Northwestern University, and a PhD from the University of California at San Diego. One of the many companies that he founded was called Chaos Telecom, which used technology based on the chaos theory concept of nonlinear dynamics. Jim's advice to students, get all the math you can. Good advice. Congratulations to Jim. Up next are the Lifetime Achievement Awards, bestowed posthumously on individuals who have achieved personal success, made an outstanding contribution to their chosen fields, and achieved recognition from their colleagues. This year, we remember 2 extraordinary alumni. Our first Lifetime Achievement Award recipient is Robert Bonthron. Bob was a member of the Illinois Tech first freshman class after the merging of Armour and Lewis Institutes, and he earned his bachelor's degree in mechanical engineering in 1944. He liked it so much here that he stuck around to earn 2 other degrees, a master's in 1952 and a PhD in 1962, both in mechanics. But even after 3 degrees, he still didn't have his fill of Illinois Tech, so he spent the next 44 years of his life devoted to the university. Let's take a quick look at some photo highlights of Bob's years at IIT, and we have a video clip of what Bob had to say about his beloved university when he spoke at our golden reunion a few years back.
I prevailed upon a member of the Vandercook School of Music, who was a jazz trumpeter, to take over, and he organized the IIT jazz band. We also had a series of meetings about opening the fog, and the vice president and treasurer was the main dissenter on the administration side. He had this vision that there would be drunken students lying all over campus if we opened the fog. But I finally convinced him that these students couldn't afford enough beer to get drunk. It was the faculty he had to worry about. He also, during that time, started a visitation program wherein the male students were permitted to visit in the women's dormitory. That was quite an innovation. Well, those 3 programs are the basis for my claim to have brought the students wine, women, and song.
Bob filled so many roles at Illinois Tech, it's nearly impossible to keep track of all the areas he impacted as a student, professor, director, even dean of students, and so much more. He was an advocate for students and remembered for being that special kind of professor who didn't just get his students, he related to them on a personal level. But there's another hat Bob wore, and that's parent of two Illinois Tech students. We're so glad that Bob's wife, Dorothy, is here with us, and sons, Brett and Scott, and their families, and there are two cousins who are alumni. They may have the market a number of alumni in the family. Brett and Scott earned their degrees in electrical engineering and mechanical engineering from Illinois Tech, I think both in 1988. Scott came back and got his MBA in 1994. At one point in Bob's career, he was a member of the faculty, a member of the administration, an alum, and the parent of two students. So I'm thinking when we sent out a mass mailing, he might have gotten a lot of copies. Bob is fondly remembered by many people at Illinois Tech for his sense of humor, his thoughtfulness, and his outstanding loyalty. He passed away in 2013 at 91 years old and had all his memories, despite the joke that he liked to tell that, quote, IIT administrators do not get old, they just lose their faculties. Thank you, higher ed joke. That is how I remember Bob, always with a joke at hand and a kind smile on his face, and we're very pleased to present this award to his sons on behalf of Bob. Congratulations. And yes, I think they did all play basketball at IIT as well. Our second Lifetime Achievement Award winner is Howard Carroll, a mechanical engineering graduate, also from the extraordinary class of 1944, who likely had a hand in getting some of you here today. Please enjoy these photos of Howard while I tell you a little about him. Howard had a long and successful career at General Motors with posts at Cadillac, Chevrolet, and Oldsmobile. He held many senior positions in the company, including executive vice president. He also worked on the Dodrill GMR Mechanical Heart Project, built by GM Research Laboratories and used in the first successful open heart operation. His love of cars started at a young age, and we're told he used to race up and down the streets of Detroit, much to the chagrin of the local police. Cars and engineering were indeed Howard's passion, but his true love, of course, was his family. He met the love of his life, Mary, who we think is watching from home. So I need everyone to turn around, look at the camera, and say hello to Mrs. Carroll. Hi, Mary. When they were both students at Wayne State University. Howard was working toward a bachelor's degree before he enlisted in the Navy during World War II. And while studying in the library, Mary tells us she looked up when someone's foot brushed hers under the table, and she and Howard, the foot's owner, were inseparable from that moment forward. They were newlyweds when Howard began working at General Motors, and naturally they bought GM cars in support of the company. But as he moved up the corporate ladder, the company began providing cars and drivers for him. They got to tool around town in all the latest models, a driving advertisement for a company that provided Howard with so much happiness. His true joy, however, was being outdoors, and he shared this love of nature with his family during wilderness camping adventures, which the grandchildren affectionately called Camp Grandpa Bud, his family nickname. Being the car guy that he was, Howard naturally loved road trips. He and his family used to drive across the country in the family car, and they would sometimes end up in one of his favorite places, the mountains of Colorado. Ever the engineer, he used the principles of torque and other engineering concepts to teach his family to ski. Howard's son David and grandson Jason, who is also an Illinois Tech graduate, are here to accept Howard's award on behalf of the family. Congratulations. The International Award of Merit is up next, given to alumni whose achievements have strengthened Illinois Tech's reputation and visibility on an international scale. This year, the International Award of Merit goes to Akihisa Miwa, our alumnus from Tokyo, Japan. Unfortunately, Aki couldn't be with us today, but President Cram will present his award on his next trip to Asia. But let me tell you a little about him. Aki started his career as an architectural engineer at Obayashi Corporation, a global contractor and one of the largest construction companies in Japan. Today, he is Obayashi's Senior Managing Executive Officer, Chief of Technology, and Chief of Nuclear Power, overseeing all technology and nuclear power system projects. Aki chose Illinois Tech for his master's degree in operations research because of the university's influential history in architecture. He oversaw the technologies used for the Tokyo Skytree, which is the tallest building in Japan, the second tallest building in the world, and the tallest telecommunication tower in the world. Tokyo Skytree was also designed by the firm led by Illinois Tech architecture alum and 2010 Alumni Medal winner Kunihiro Misu. For this reason, former Illinois Tech President John Anderson has officially renamed Skytree, calling it the IIT Tower in Tokyo. Congratulations to Aki. Next, we have the Alumni Service Award, which honors alumni who demonstrate commitment to and enthusiasm for Illinois Tech through their involvement in varied arenas of the university. And if you look it up in the dictionary, the answer to that description is Vasudevan Rajaram, Raj as we know him. Raj was already a successful engineer and business owner when he decided to go to law school. He enrolled in the Energy and Environmental Law program at Chicago Kent College of Law and went to school by night and ran his company by day. Raj tells us he graduated in 1991 ready to change the world, but quickly found out that the law world was not so interested in a 42-year-old with lots of life experience, but no law experience. So he shifted his focus back to engineering, where he found his new law degree was valuable to help legal issues in the business world. In 2006, Raj shifted his focus again, becoming a part-time engineer and a full-time advocate. He says he has found true fulfillment through the work he does fundraising for projects that help the poorest in India get clean water, sanitation, and eye care, among other necessities. Raj became involved in social advocacy through a lecture he attended by Anton Valukas, who encouraged all lawyers to tutor in their communities, a sentiment he took to heart and has kept to this day. Raj has raised hundreds of thousands of dollars for education in India. He tells us he believes everyone deserves the same educational opportunities he had. Now, as a fundraiser myself, I know it's not always easy to ask others for money, but Raj says it's not hard for him. He says, I tell them it's not for me, it's for my boss, a third grader in India. Lucky for us, Raj gives his philanthropic skills to Illinois Tech causes as well. Among other initiatives, he has raised funds for the International Student Scholarship and brought long-distance learning classes to India through the Stewart School of Business. Last year, we recognized Raj for his 7-year service to the Alumni Association Board of Directors. During his time on the board, he was the brainchild, event chair, key driver, energizer bunny of the highly successful 2014 Global Alumni Gathering held in Chicago. This was the first time we'd ever done this, and it gathered more than 300 alumni and guests from 19 countries for special events that coincided with homecoming, which brought a total of more than 600 alumni on campus that weekend. Thank you for everything you've done. Congratulations, Raj. Up next is the Collins Merit Award, named for former Illinois Tech President Lou Collins. This award honors alumni for their outstanding commitment to the future of the university through philanthropic contributions paired with involvement in their gift. Ron Hochsprung, who earned his computer science degree in 1972, is this year's recipient. Ron spent 33 years at Apple, helping forge new frontiers in technology, and at many times interacting with founder and CEO Steve Jobs. Ron gave us the Lisa and the Macintosh computers and Thunderbolt technology, but he admits he didn't know all that much about computers before he came to Illinois Tech. There just weren't that many of them around in 1961. In fact, he came to Illinois Tech as a physics major. He took a computer programming class his sophomore year and says his life was changed. He began working in the computer center and took a hiatus from his academic pursuits. He worked with several different machines, including a UNIVAC 1108, which was housed in an old auto showroom on the other side of Michigan Avenue because it was too big to keep on campus. The disk drive alone, which was a drum in those days, weighed several tons. Soon he continued his classes, earned his degree, and headed to the West Coast to be more involved in the future of computers. He calls himself a loose cannon and loved that for many years his job was essentially to play with a new toy every day. Never got bored because he never did the same thing twice. In 2011, he decided he wanted to get in touch with his roots and re-engage with Illinois Tech. He and his wife, Linda, who's here with him today, established a scholarship fund for Illinois Tech students. Ron had received a scholarship when he was a student, and he wanted to pay it forward. But he didn't stop there. After everything he had done in the 60s and 70s for computer science at Illinois Tech, teaching, developing, coding, languages and systems, exposing high schoolers to the department, he still wanted to do more. So in 2013, he established the Ron Hochsprung Endowed Chair in Computer Science, the department's first endowed chair. Endowed chairs help us attract the best faculty members, like Una Santos, the current Hochsprung Endowed Chairholder in Computer Science, who is here with us today. Ron, we thank you for becoming one of Illinois Tech's greatest philanthropists. Your foresight will strengthen the computer science department for generations to come. We have a special way of thanking Ron at Illinois Tech. Congratulations. How do you do this? Okay, we have to explain. So Ron, you pass Ron on the street, you might think he's a very serious man. But he tends to have a red nose in his pocket at all times. And whenever he needs a smile, he wants to share one with you, or there's a stressful moment in the day, Ron puts his nose on. We love that about you. We have pictures of Ron wearing his nose all over campus. Congratulations, Ron. Bonnie, we'll need a red nose photo at the end. Our final award today is the Alumni Medal, the highest honor given to a living alumnus. And as you can see in the back of your program book, this award has a very illustrious list of recipients. These recipients exhibit qualities of the Alumni Service Award, the Collins Award, and the Professional Achievement Award, all rolled into one. The names of the Alumni Medal recipients are also commemorated on a plaque just outside the ballroom door, listing all the Alumni Medal winners. But before we present this year's medal, let's learn a little about our recipient with this video featuring President Cram and University Regent Craig Duchossois.
The Alumni Medal is the highest honor bestowed by the Illinois Institute of Technology Alumni Association. Since 1890, we've given this award to only 53 alumni. This year's recipient, Bud Wendorf, is a role model, a mentor, and an inspiration. But these are just a few of the words that describe him. At Illinois Tech, we see him as...
Oh, Bud's very enthusiastic about everything he does. I mean, if you talk to him at all, you can hear about his grandchildren. You can hear about the wonderful vacations that he goes on. You can hear about his love for Formula One racing. So he's very enthusiastic about everything, you know. And I think that's just part of his personality, that if he decides to do something, he gives everything.
Well, it's obvious to me that Bud must have been blessed with outstanding parents. His leadership is compassionate, it's proactive, He's imaginative, and like most great engineers, he understands how to get into the details before he makes a decision.
I think that Bud is very deliberate in his decision-making and in his actions. Once he's decided what he should do, he does it. And it's very clear he's doing it. There's no other path. And I think that's one of his great strengths, that he follows through in what he says he's going to do.
I think Bud loved his job, he loved his people, he loved his company. And as he retired, he's now morphed that love and that passion to IIT, for which all of us are very grateful.
You know, whenever you become president of a university, one of the things that concerns you most is who are you going to work for? And although you work for the board and we have 70 members, you know you're really working for the chairman of the board. So knowing Bud, it made it very easy for me to accept being president because I knew we could work together and I knew he would be a good person to work with.
At one of our first board meetings together, Bud and I were at a high top having a cocktail and really talking about the wonderful, rewarding, and intrinsic satisfaction we received by being involved with the IIT Board of Trustees. And we said, well, what can we do about it? And half joking, we said, well, let's do a tie. This is your tie, and I'm proud to have it on, and you started a tradition that'll carry on for many, many generations to come.
Thanks to Craig and Alan for that video. Now it's my turn to tell you a little about Bud. Bud was raised in Milwaukee by loving parents who instilled values of integrity, service, and hard work in their three children. His sister Diane and her husband Chuck is here with us today. Growing up during the Cold War and the space race, he says that like a lot of other kids in the era, he felt a duty to, quote, not waste his brain and do well in school. Luckily for us, Bud's high school counselor suggested Illinois Tech. His mother even went back to work to help pay for the tuition so that he could get his degree in mechanical engineering. That, I love that one. In the middle. In the middle. Is the guy in the flowered pants here? That would be fun. Once on campus, Bud quickly found a second home in his fraternity, Pi Kappa Phi. Despite the rigorous coursework, he says that he managed to make a little time for fun, including outings to Shorty Brown's, anybody know that? The neighborhood watering hole at the time at 29th and Princeton. We understand that Shorty might have witnessed Bud celebrate his 21st birthday more than once, but hijinks aside, it was his role as president of the fraternity house where he really honed his leadership skills that would serve him throughout his career. He tells us that the mediation expertise required to help his fraternity brothers get out of jams taught him a lot about being a leader and understanding various points of view. Throughout college, Bud took many trips on a Greyhound bus to Milwaukee to see his junior high school sweetheart, Susie. Can we have an aw here? Aw, aw. I'm gonna embarrass her, make her stand up. Come on, come on. Thank you. After his graduation, they married and embarked on building this wonderful life together. If she cries, I'm going to cry. This is very, very hard. This is a tough one. And what a life you've built. 45th anniversary this spring. Sally and Matthew Dwan here with them today. While working in his first engineering job at Westinghouse, Bud was recruited to Sergeant in Lundy and calls it one of the luckiest events of his life. His career there spanned 41 years, culminating in his role as chairman and CEO, where he traveled the globe to help build the company into a world leader in professional services for the electric power industry. He credits much of his career success to his ability to learn a little bit about each area of the business and to the many good friends who supported him along the way. We're so glad to have so many Sergeant and alumni friends here today to help honor Bud, make you all stand up back there, and many of them are IIT alumni. Please welcome the Sergeant Lundy team. Come on, don't be shy. And as Bud rose through the ranks, he began to give back to his alma mater, serving on the alumni board, the Board of Trustees, and since 2014, leading the university as chairman of the board. Bud and Susie have also given generously to Illinois Tech and have established a scholarship for graduates of the Chicago Public Schools. But beyond their philanthropy, they're also very actively involved with their scholars and serve as wonderful role models for the students. One of their former scholars, Carlos Viramontes, is here with us today, sitting with the Sergeant Lundy crowd, to help us honor Bud. Carlos was the second Wendorf Scholar and is a double alum with a bachelor's and master's degree in architectural engineering from IIT. He's now working for VMA Consulting Engineers as a mechanical engineer, thanks to the Wendorfs. Bud's father, awesome picture, who was a hardworking building engineer, couldn't be with us today, but I've had the honor to meet him, and we're sure that Mr. Wendorf might be watching online, so we need another turn and wave to Bud's dad, because he's quite an internet whiz at the young age of 95. Bud picked up a passion for cars while watching his father fix the family vehicles. He recalls his first car as a beautiful 1957 Buick, although he didn't buy it until many years after 1957. Just as his first classic car, Bud Wendorf has become somewhat of an IIT classic. Bud, for all you've done for your profession, your community, and your alma mater, we salute you. Congratulations on receiving the 2016 Illinois Tech Alumni Medal. And please come say a few words. Keep it in the middle. Hold the award. We'd love to hear from you, Bud.
You would love to hear from me, but not for too long, right? Well, thank you. Truly, I'm proud to win this award, but I'm also, based on all of the previous recipients and the things that we heard here today of the alums of from IIT, I'm humbled to win this award and really thank you for it. I was thinking, I believe many know that Betsy recently went through some really serious back surgery, and she's bounced back wonderfully and doing very well. And she really is the cornerstone of this day. I have to admit, I was a little bit concerned that she would be here, because she has that way of making us sound better than we are. So I thank you, Betsy. It's been a wonderful day, and you've done a great job with this luncheon today. I guess I wanted to talk a little bit. I think the notion of this award is the service that I've been able to provide to IIT. And I guess I was thinking it in terms of, if you looked at me, maybe you'd recognize that I have a few miles on the odometer and have gotten to the point of my life where, you know, there's a lot of things that become optional, that in your younger parts of your career you have to worry about getting a job and keeping a job and raising a family and so forth. But I guess I enjoy being retired, being at the point in my life where I can make choices to do the things that I like to do. And I think that comes back to the area of my perspective of the work here. I used to always say to the folks at Sergeant and Lundy that it's important when you're in an endeavor that you have to make a judgment. Are you taking out more, or are you contributing more? And certainly, I feel that the time I spend and the things that go on that can help out a little bit at IIT, I certainly gained from it far more than I am able to provide. You know, it's very refreshing to see the amazing students and what they are doing, what they accomplish, and we attend some of the functions where they have the student speakers, and it almost brings a tear to your eye to see the talent and the good work that really gets done. So it's a very positive atmosphere, a very positive thing for us. And I wanted to just piggyback a little bit onto Alan's comments from earlier in the day when he talked about what IIT does to further, you know, students that need a little bit of help, and we can push them along. Many of you closely affiliated with Illinois Tech know the story, but I'd like to repeat it for some that don't, which is the story of the million-dollar speech. And it was the minister in this area back, you know, 125 years ago, Frank Gonzalez, who gave the speech. He was a local minister in this community. He said, if I had $1 million, I could start a school where all students, not just privileged, but all students could be taught and prepared to deal with this thing called the Industrial Revolution. And Philip Armour was in the congregation today, that day, and I suppose there was a little negotiation, but he did write that check for $1 million. And as Alan had clearly indicated, that gene of within the university has always been there. It was there from 125 years ago. That perspective, that view has remained. And I think that's really why I feel really good about being able to be of some service to this really cool place. Just as a close, I'd like to just thank a few people. Clearly, there's so many wonderful people doing such great jobs here. You couldn't identify them all, but I would like, because you know where I spend a good bit of time, I really appreciate the talent, the knowledge, the friendship of Alan Cram, our president. I enjoyed a wonderful relationship with his predecessor, John Anderson, another remarkable individual who's done so well, and I've really, really found the Board of Trustees to me to be amazing. The people that I work with on the board, they're so smart, successful, done so many things, but yet have collectively been so generous to making Illinois Tech what it is and able to move forward. And finally, I'd like to thank Susie. Betsy recognized Susie. She's getting a phone call. We'll take a minute there. But here's a thought that I wanted to recognize how lucky I am to have a person like her. You know, you get called upon to go to functions and things. And for me, it's oftentimes that IIT people that I'm working with or know and so forth. But she comes to these things with me, never, and it's hard. It's, you know, I mean, if you ever have to go to things, you don't know people and whatever, but she does such a wonderful job, never complains, yeah, let's do that, and finds these events and activities very interesting, and I appreciate that. So all in all, thank you all. I think it's been a very interesting day. And I truly appreciate this award, and I will always cherish it. Thank you.
One more round of applause for all of today's winners. You know, these awards are a very important and wonderful tradition, and we don't have enough traditions at this place. So here's my big pitch for you to help us out. This is the 70th year we've been giving these awards, and we need your help for year 71, right? So the thing that drives me crazy about you people, and I've worked here a long time so I can say this, is you're too modest. You don't brag about yourselves. You don't brag about each other. So here's my pitch to please brag and nominate yourself or your classmate or your professional colleague to be a winner at the 2017 Alumni Awards. The deadline is October 31st of each year. You'll find the really easy nomination form online at iit.edu. So please help us with that. I also want to thank the team that made this event possible. There are many of them. They're hovering in the back. They were greeting you out front. But two in particular, Jamie Acton, our Senior Director of Alumni Relations, and his team, and Lisa Nata, our Senior Director of Communications, who writes these beautiful scripts and stories about all of you. So our thanks to the Institutional Advancement Team for making this happen. And a final note for those of you who are in the Chicago area, we have a wonderful event coming up on May 5th that I want you to know about. As we heard, Alan Cram has been traveling the country on his inauguration tour, and Chicago is actually the final stop on the year. So on May 5th, at the headquarters of Scott Turnowitz's company, Gravity Tank, you'll be able to learn about the NIAIR Prize finalist teams and their exciting research. Board of Trustees member Madhavan Nair, who inspired and funded the NIAIR Prize, is here today. Of course, today I have to tell you he's also a former Collins Award of Merit winner. But he has made this extraordinary gift to the university that has inspired teams of faculty in their wonderful research to solve problems that are of great importance to our time. And you'll get to hear the presentations, brief presentations by each of those teams, and you'll get a chance to thank Madhavan for helping the university. You can find that online as well to sign up for the May 5th alumni event. Now, to the alumni who haven't been to campus in a long time, thank you so much for coming. And I do hope you'll take a little time to wander around campus, stop a student and talk to them. They'll be happy to point you on your way. But I also hope you might be inspired by some of these winners who joyfully tell you of their experience being involved in IT. And if you'd like to join that group of volunteers, grab any of my colleagues with a name tag, and we'd love to get you involved in your alma mater. This has been a lot of fun. I'd like you all to know that it's not quite 2 o'clock, so we even beat our schedule. Thank you so much for coming. Congratulations once again to all our winners, and we'll see you next year.